Hello, I'm Mr. Army Curie, retired lecturer in metallurgy. I'm a scientist. And I'm preaching Christianity and its continuation, Sikhism. Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. But this thing is known to hardly anyone. Gospel is for 1 in 1,000 and 2 in 10,000. Gospel cannot be written down in ink on paper, but over the living tablet of heart through logical reasoning. If you are not capable of logical reasoning, you can't have gospel. But the dead letters which they ply in the universities to get you degrees, to earn money, they work for mammon, doctor, priest, and not for God. In mammon, as Judas Iscariot, he loved mammon. He was stealing money from the purse. And so these dog-collar priests in the churches, they steal money from the church purse. They are Judas Iscariot in sheep's clothing. They work for mammon and not for God. They give lip service, not of the heart. Heart is given by the royal priest. And they are the ones who are mammon free. That's why the people who found the first church of God, headed by Christ Jesus, they all got rid of their worldly possessions. And they joined the first community. And Peter was the gatekeeper. And two, Ananias and Sapphira, they sold their possessions, but they kept back money, mammon. So they have one finger in mammon and one finger, they wanted to join the church of God, which Peter refused and killed them on the spot. They told blasphemy to Peter that come from your heart. In Jesus, sin have no meaning. Sin is transgression against the moral law, and John the Baptist was the last prophet. And they teach the moral laws. So, moral laws are here. This is John the Baptist. Last one, a witness to the light, but not the light. Here we have prophet here. Angel, prophet, messenger. 70 outer circle, laborer were this one. Prepared in this outer one, outer circle. And this is the inner circle. Christ Jesus had 12 laborers. 7 were in the name of John the Baptist and 5 in the name of Christ Jesus of heart. 7 concerning morality and 5 concerning spirituality. So they were perfect. Perfect, you know, pure. Their hearts were clean, white. Remember that when Jesus went to Samaritan village, and this Samaritan woman at well, she was well knowledgeable in gospel or in the scripture. So she vetted Jesus in Holy Spirit, not looking at the book what to ask him. In Holy Spirit she vetted Jesus and told him that you are a prophet. And then she said, when Christ comes, he will tell us everything. So she knew the difference between prophet and Christ. So this is the prophet here, which is reflection to the light. And here is the Christ, the very source of light. Very source of light. Then he will tell us everything. So in Christ Jesus, you learn everything you want to know. You get the bottom line truth, rock, over which you can build your house. Rock. And people these days, they build houses on sand. Sand means that their foundations are not sound. Whatever they talk does not make sense. So with this introduction, and here is Adam. Under Adam come races. Under races comes tribes. Tribes, surnames, and so and so. No Jew here. This planet Earth is for the habitation of the sons of Adam, noble people. when you become Jew outwardly, you put Jew here, then you can't build your covenant with Adam. Same way Origen, one of the church fathers, you know, he's trying to build the covenant of Jews with Abraham. He said, Abraham was not a Jew. Up to Isaac he can go, but not up to Abraham. Because Abraham, if he was Jew, then the people of Ishmael would have been Jew as well. So that is their man, he was a man of dead letters. And that is their church father, one of them. So you can see, these dead people in Holy Spirit, which is common sense, and they are worshipping those who are dead in letters, like Origen. And that is their father, you know, church fathers. So you can see what you expect from them. So, there is the kingdom of heaven and hell, which was the keys, was with the rabbis. And when they became corrupt, and they become liar and all that, and here come the sin also. Then Jesus opened the royal kingdom of God, which is here, which is within our heart. And this kingdom he was proclaiming, and those temple priests, clever ones, they to incite Pilate that he is proclaiming to be the king. So they told Pilate that, hey, this man say he is the king. He has the royal kingdom. And when they told him, accused him that he is a king, rebellion against Pilate, so that Pilate can kill him, you know, properly. So Pilate happened to ask Jesus, what is the truth? Jesus said, if my kingdom was outside, as this is of the rabbis, my soldiers would have come to fight against Jews, but mine is opposite, inside my heart, not outside. He understood it. He went to the Jews to tell them that he had done nothing wrong to deserve death penalty. And they shouted more and more, as you have protest in the country, you know, and you make the garments to bend down. So they shouted more, and then Pilate, fed up with them, said, okay, I'm going to wash my hand under sun, primary source of light, and you do with this man whatever you want to do. I have nothing to do with the blood of this man. They said, this blood of this man is on us and on our children. And that is what happened there. So, this is the, which one? This is the kingdom of heaven and hell, which you can see. And this you can't see, you have to perceive through deeds. What karma he does. This is by birth seen. This is by deeds, karma, works, you know, sorry. And this is the two kingdom, gods, demiurge and the real. Jesus, these parts, three here, kind of. Some are holy, some are evil. Works, they are of works. And middle is of grace. Now these parts, they are the one which is visible. They are doing social, ecumenical and political affairs. So you can watch the men. You can see them with two naked eyes. So the name Yahshua is here. This is the creation of Yahweh, Brahma, Khudah. We call it Sarishhtti, nature. Sarishhtti in Hindi. And nature in English, you know, nature at large, what you can see with the two naked eyes. So the soul in them which make them living, which you can't see. That's why Jesus told to Nicodemus, you see the leaf moving, but what make them move, you cannot see. You see the people moving around, but what make them move around, which is the soul, you can't see, but you have to perceive. So this is a soul, That comes from our supernatural father, God, which is called Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm. So there, this is demiurge creation, which you can see, and this is our supernatural. And this supernatural knowledge is by the grace of our supernatural father. Nobody else can have it. Other people just ply dead letters as these people. They see but not perceive. The root of the scripture is oral Torah. Oral Torah is the top root of scripture. That you can't see, but you perceive. If the top root is green, moral laws of sound. If the top root is dead, as the Jewish people were, their moral laws were corrupt. So the moral laws of the Samaritans, their top root was green, and they were living, and they were correct. They went by their heart. Gentile never dies, for he does not live to die. Samaritan man who picked up the wounded person, he went by his heart. Whereas the other Pharisee and Sadducee, they went by the book, that this man doesn't belong to us. They went under eros. And Samaritan man went under agape, man of spirit. So, this, our supernatural soul, is everyone, whether it's evil or good. So in our supernatural father, we hate none. Evil and good one, they are treated alike. So that's why in Bhakti Maharaj or in Jesus, we have no enemy, no stranger to us. All are equal to us. So you preach gospel as the rain falls on good and the evil, and so does this gospel. It preached to both good and evil. So we hope this will make clear. We have two gods, demiurge, Yahweh, Brahma, Khudah, which is the Lord of nature. They are the Lord. We have Father of our souls, which is Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, which is supernatural Father, and this is natural Father. Created. So Jesus' Hebrew name Yahshua is made of two words, Yah from Yahweh, and Shua or Shiva means the primal Adam. So Jesus was the firstborn of Yahweh, the second Adam. So Mary was sired by Yahweh. He was the second Adam. So in first Adam, we are born and die. And the second Adam, we are resurrected as in Christ Jesus. I've written something I would write, show you, but with this our background, you know. So he had 12 laborers, Jesus, as it is written at the bottom. 7 were in the name of John the Baptist for morality, and 5 in the name of Christ Jesus, which is of heart. The 5 husbands of the Samaritan woman, and which is for spirituality. In a house, there are 5, 3 against 2, 2 against 3, and all that knowledge. You get all this by Holy Spirit, and not by reading books. Books give you dead letters and make you drunk with the old wine of the old wine. Okay, okay. So here is the kingdom, the blow, John the Baptist is here, holding scripture. And here is the royal kingdom, no scripture, no letters. Here our covenant is of Holy Spirit. And here our covenant is of flesh, letters here, scripture. Luke 16, verse 16, law and prophets were till John the Baptist. So transgression against the moral law is sin. So sin comes here and blasphemy comes here. Transgression against the Holy Spirit, blasphemy, which is not forgivable. This is forgivable. Moral laws are made by men and men forgive them. So John the Baptist baptized Jewish men in water in the name of Abraham and he baptized Jesus in the name of his heavenly Father, Yahweh. That was his court where they were selling cattle, money changers. And when he was of age, then he turned their table and told them, "This, my Father's house is for prayer and fasting, and not for selling money changers and other things." Much more I can tell. He turned their table, made a whip in the name of Yahweh, jealous and revengeful. In the name of our supernatural Father, he said, "If somebody hit you, present the other cheek." So you can see the difference between the two. What applied to flesh, the opposite applied to spirit. So people who came to John the Baptist, they realized that if they become Jew outwardly, as they were making in the temple of appearances, you break your covenant with Abraham, because he was not a Jew outwardly. He was a Semitic race. Otherwise, Ishmael people would have been Jew as well. So they came to John the Baptist to be baptized in repentance, because when they were children, they were groomed that they are Jew outwardly. But when they grow up, they realize it's wrong, and they won't go to synagogue and other things, you know, because they were babblers. And they were called sinners by them for breaking the moral law of Moses. So they came to John the Baptist to be baptized in water in the name of Abraham, to become faithful sons of Abraham, salt of the earth. Remember that Abraham was a noble man, as Stephen, when he went to the temple, he told them, "Our forefather Abraham was a noble man, and don't make fake sons of Abraham through circumcision." Circumcision is the tribal mark of Abraham to Isaac. Only the generation of Isaac can have circumcision, nobody else. But in the temple, they were making Gentile and other people who were not the born of the seed of Isaac, they were circumcising them and making them view outwardly. And that's why St. Paul bring one of their customers, you know, that here is one, you can circumcise him and make him view outwardly for your money. But in this age, the circumcision of the flesh does not count. Our circumcision of heart is concerned. Heart is here. So heart, you have to be circumcised to serve God, and not the Satan. So here, Holy Spirit, transgression against the Holy Spirit, blasphemy. And most of these politicians, they are blasphemers. Like Tony Blair and Bush, they said Saddam Hussein has weapons of mass destruction. A major general army, he lives near Reading, and he came to Reading to give a sermon on Christian men's breakfast. And I was there. So those people asked him, you know, "You are in Iraq. Did Saddam Hussein had any weapons of mass destruction?" He told them, "No, not at all. None at all." So what they told that he has weapon of mass destruction was a blasphemy from the core of their heart. As Onions and Sapphira told, that's all they have got. So Peter killed them. So these Tony Blair and Bush, they were blasphemers. And how people admire them, you can well imagine. So the destruction of Iraq was at the instigation of the Jewish people in America, which hold the Mammon and Media. Mammon and Media is in the hand of Jews, and where God is on the right hand side, no Mammon, Mammon free. That's why people, Matthew, when joined hands with Jesus, he sold half of his, gave away half of his possessions to the poor. Became Mammon, half belonged to his wife, because in soul, you know, spirit, the woman also had the same right as the man. It is under moral laws that she doesn't have. She is a chattel under moral laws, but no more chattel in God. So in your soul, your even your family, wife, children, everybody is your brother. And no more wife or other relations, because only soul is concerned, which are the same in your children. So this concept is very hard to for the once-born people to grasp. So, they, at the instigation of these Jewish people in America, Mammon and media, which is America is a colony of Israel. America is a colony of Israel. So Mammon and media is in their hand, and they, whatever they tell the politicians, they do it. Otherwise, they are thrown out through propaganda. Mammon and media. So it was they who told the American government, we are frightened of that Saddam Hussein and destroy that country. So they destroyed Saddam Hussein and his country. And that place, Iraq, is the cradle of humanity. Remember that Yahweh is the farmer. Matthew 13, verse 24 to 30. Yahweh is the farmer. He sowed good seed, sons of Adam, sons of man. And Satan at night, night means religious darkness. This is the age of religious darkness. He came and sowed his tares. And in the morning, the angels that means of the order of John the Baptist. So they went to see the field and they found tares. And they told the farmer, Yahweh, shall we uproot them? He said, no, no, leave them. When end of the age, which is now, comes, I will bundle them up and burn them. And they are getting bundled up in Israel for final burning. Their 70 years are over, and now they are left with 5 years of grace. So in 2023 could be the atomic war. So it's not far away. So you will see a lot of tribulation in this period now. So that's of heart, five. And seven in the name of John the Baptist, making it 12. Nothing to do with the 12 tribes of Israel. Because nothing to do with flesh. It's all spiritual knowledge. So it has been twisted in the books, you know. So Bible is not the word of God, as people say. It is twisted, and unless you understand the hidden treasures, you can't know the gospel. That's why a man who found treasures hidden in the field, he covered it up because nobody else believed in. It is for him only. Gospel is received on individual basis, not on everybody can get it. By the grace of our supernatural Father. Peter could not get gospel because he was once born. Only once when he told Jesus that you are the Messiah, at that time he got the gospel truth. But he became arrogant and started rebuking Jesus afterward. So Jesus then rebuked him. I call him a stumbling block. Because once-born people, they don't understand gospel, so they try keep on arguing with you. This is written in the Bible, this is written in this book and that book, not knowing that gospel cannot be written down in ink or paper, but over the living tablet of heart through logical reasoning. And that is by the grace of our supernatural Father. Nobody else can have it. So, this is the below, which is the word of rabbis, in which they teach moral law, and you have male and female, families and all that, you know. And here is the spiritual word of Christ Jesus. You have to go enter here, solitary and humble, low, and enter the spiritual word, which is of sadhus, Melchizedek. If you ask sadhu, what is your tribe? He said, we became sadhu, we don't have tribe. But if you ask him, in which tribe God gave you the birth, then they will tell you, not otherwise. So they have no tribal identity here, because the soul is concerned. So our covenant here is of Holy Spirit with Christ Jesus. So you must turn the seed into plant and then get it grafted to true vine, Christ Jesus, to have your daily bread of life. Then digest it over your heart through logical reasoning, and then preach gospel from your own heart, not from the book, as they do it in the university. They are producing super donkeys carrying holy books in the universities. So then you preach gospel here. You learn here and come out. They are saint, here are prophet and angels. So with this knowledge, I hope it will make it clear. So less than I've written something, then it will make it all clear to you. Somebody, you know, from Biola University wrote to me that he wanted some remark on what is their faith, you know. There's the covenant, you know. Hi, Brother Joshua. Joshua was his name. Here are my deliberations. First of all, you are men of the dead letters, and our covenant with God called Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc., our supernatural father who is represented by sons and not daughters. In him, we are called fishers of spiritual twice-born men that are capable of entering into the royal kingdom of God that is within your own heart. And it has a low for humble and narrow for the solitary, whether in flesh, they are male or female, but in spirit they are all sons of the highest Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm. And that is what Jesus came to turn the sons of man, faithful to Abraham and Yahweh, prepared by John the Baptist and the 70 outer circle laborers, that Jesus prepared to deal with the moral issues in the name of John the Baptist. And they were not solitary as the secular bird is of pairs, but went in pairs, so they went in pairs. They baptized Jewish men in water in the name of Abraham, making them the salt of the earth, the physical body covenant with ideal Adam, Abraham. Abraham was the ideal Adam, Sarah was Eve, and the promised land, Garden of Eden. In the first Adam, we are born and die, reincarnation, through works, and perform works for reincarnation, whilst the second Adam, Yahshua, from Yahweh, Shua or Shiva, Shua means Shiva, the primal Adam, firstborn of Yahweh, the second floating Adam, became floating. Foxes are told to rest their head, the son of man has none because he was floating. We are resurrected. Thus Mary was sired by Yahweh, Brahma, Khudah, etc., the lord of nature, called Sarishhtti. So this statement, the article of faith presented here, as originally conceived by the founders of the organization, have been and continue to be the stated theological position of Biola University, and are an essential part of the Article of Incorporation of the University, where man is used referring to the human race. It includes both genders. This is wrong, because in Christ Jesus we have no gender. Our soul is neither male nor female, nor Jew nor Gentile. No, nothing to do with flesh. It's purely spiritual. Word of sadhu called celestial word. All the words that he spoke during his earthly life, that is what they say, were the words of God called oral Torah. There is absolutely no error of any kind in them. That means what is written is incorruptible, but it is corruptible. What is received, his word, which is brand new, untouched cloth by human hand, that means revelation, is not corruptible. And by the word of Jesus Christ, they don't know the, it is Christ Jesus, not Jesus Christ. Christ is the title. Jesus was his name. Not, you don't put Professor Smith John, but you put Professor John Smith. Seth Smith is his surname. The words of all other teachers must be tested. Word of God called Oral Torah because it cannot be written down in ink on paper as you receive it through logical reasoning called revelation. That only the twice-born people receive it through logical reasoning. That only the twice-born people seeking him get it as the sadhu Melchizedek did. So something this is written, you know. I hope it's made clear. I don't want to carry on with it because I become too lengthy. And our Father God blesses everyone in Holy Spirit, in agape, the divine love in which we hate none, we love all.